Last week, Bobby Brown hit number one for his first time with My Prerogative. Will he hang on to the top spot for a second week, or will Phil Collins break into number one territory with Two Hearts? Plus, we'll talk to Bobby Brown, and we'll have a very special preview of the Michael Jackson home video, Moonwalker.
Oh, you pin-torn, lily-livered, sad-winding steel.
You hairball! I asked for a bad guy, and he gives me Michael Jackson!
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to America's Top 10. Let's get right to the countdown. After debuting last week at number 9, Annie Lennox and Al Green slip a notch to 10 with their remake of Put a Little Love in Your Heart. As we've mentioned, this is Al Green's first pop chart appearance since 1976. And the reason for that is his career as a minister and gospel singer. Here's a bit of the gospel Al Green in action. A look at Al Green singing gospel. Now here's the pop side of the Reverend Al Green in his duet with Annie Lennox and Put a Little Love in Your Heart. Annie Lennox and Al Green with a hit from the soundtrack of the movie Scrooge, Put a Little Love in Your Heart. The first of the two new songs in our survey rockets in from 14 to 9. And it's the second top 10 hit for a hard rocking band from Brooklyn, New York, who are having their current success with a ballad. Here's White Lion, debuting with When the Children Cry. White Lion hit the top 10 last year with their song Wait. This year they do it again with When the Children Cry. The first of the two solo women in our survey climbs from number 10 to number 8 this week. She's a woman who got her start like so many others, singing in her church. Then she worked with the soul singer who calls himself O'Brien and with Jeff Lorber. And she's having her biggest success by herself. Karen White at number 8 with The Way You Love Me. Singer from Los Angeles, Karen White at number 8 in our survey with The Way You Love Me, as the countdown continues on the way to the number 1 song in the USA.
America's Top 10 is brought to you in part by Nestle's. And coming up next, Poison. And we'll have a special preview of Michael Jackson's upcoming home video, Moonwalker.
Brett Michaels of Poison. I'm young, single, and loves to mingle, and you're watching America's Top 10. Ow!
Holding at number 7 for a second week is Michael Jackson with his first hit from the soundtrack of his just-released home video, Moonwalker, a home video that set a new record for music videos, the largest advanced order in history. Here's a special America's Top 10 preview. Now, here's Michael Jackson at number 7 with Smooth Criminal. Michael Jackson with his 21st top 10 solo hit at number 7 with Smooth Criminal. Falling three notches to number 6 is the band from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Poison, with their recent number 1 song, Every Rose Has Its Thorn. With Bret Michaels on lead vocals, that's Poison at number 6 with Every Rose Has Its Thorn. And the second of the two new songs in our survey, pole vaults in at number 5. It's the first and only hit for a Canadian band that split up 4 years ago. The band is gone, but Sheriff's Music lives on with When I'm With You, as the countdown continues on our way to the number 1 song in the USA.
America's Top 10 is brought to you in part by Oxy. And coming up next, we'll see Taylor Dane, Bobby Brown, and Def Leppard.
Touring is like you get a chance to meet all the people that buy your records. You get a chance to, you know, thank all the people that buy your records. And you also get a chance to, you know, show them what your personality is about. You get a chance to, you know, act wild. You get a chance to do anything you want to do on tour.
That touring has paid off for Bobby Brown, giving him a number one album and a number one song. And after 1 week at number 1, it falls to number 4. Here's Bobby Brown's My Prerogative. Bobby Brown falling to number 4 this week with last week's number 1 song, My Prerogative. Well, there are 3 heavy metal bands in this week's survey, but only one of them is in with a heavy metal hit. Both Poison and White Lion are in with ballads, but Def Leppard is busy upholding the faith. They climb two notches to number three this week, kicking off the jams with Armageddon. Second band from Sheffield, England, Def Leppard, at number three this week with Armageddon. The second of the two solo women in our survey climbs a fast two notches to number two with her fourth consecutive top ten hit, Taylor Dane, and Don't Rush Me. Taylor Dane at number two with her follow-up to I'll Always Love You, Don't Rush Me. Now, let's take a look at the hottest films in the land over the past couple of weeks. At number 10, Hellbound Hellraiser 2. At number 9, Scrooge. 8, Oliver and Company. 7, Tequila Sunrise. 6, Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. 5, Naked Gun. 4, Working Girl. And debuting in the top 10 at number 3, Accidental Tourist. Number 2, Twins. And the number 1 film in the land again this week, Dustin Hoffman and Tom Cruise in Rain Man.
Ray, can we try something?
Yeah.
Do you know how much 312 times 123 is?
38376.
Yes, sir. You gotta love this film. For the second week in a row, that's the most popular film in the USA, Rain Man. The new number one song in a moment. And we'll answer our trivia question. A viewer in North Dakota wants to know, who's the first black performer to hit number one on the country chart? Well, he's a man who takes pride in his phenomenal 29 number one songs on the country chart. Details coming up. And now, we're up to the new number one song in the land this week. It is the sixth number one for a superstar drummer from London who's been to the top with Against All Odds, One More Night, To Studio, Separate Lives, Groovy Kind of Love, and his current number one song. From the soundtrack of the movie Buster, here is Phil Collins and Two Hearts. Of Phil Collins' six number ones, four have been for movie soundtracks, including the latest at number one this week, Two Hearts. Now, let's answer our trivia question. It comes to us from John Machesek of Langdon, North Dakota. John wants to know, who's the first black performer to hit number one on the country chart? Well, he's also the most successful black act in country chart history, a man who has had a phenomenal 29 number one songs on the country chart. And they all began back in 1969 with a song called All I Have to Offer You Is Me, the very first number one for country superstar Charlie Pride. There's your answer, John. Thanks for writing in.
And because America's Top 10 used John's question, he'll receive Gitano, always on the cutting edge of fashion and design, offering up-to-the-minute styling and exceptional quality. Gitano. And join the movement with Jacques Moray Bodywear, an American favorite with an extensive selection in fashion for action. Moray moves like your second skin. And Hitachi's VCR with digital VU transmitter and automatic functions. Just touch the remote control for an on-screen guide to programming and playback procedures. Hitachi.
Now, let's take a look at three of the biggest movers on Billboard's Hot 100 this week. The hits Billboard says are the hottest new songs in the land. Three of the biggest movers, according to Billboard magazine. Well, that wraps up our show for this week. Join us again next week as we count down the hottest hits in the USA. Till then, keep your feet in the ground and keep reaching for the stars. Think about your car that's burning. I'm a guy.